sanity.
When I was a young boy, when I was looking forward to a particular day like my birthday, my mother used to stick little stones on my windowsill, you know, of my bedroom. And if it was 15 days until my birthday, she'd put 15 stones. And every day I used to throw a stone out the window so I could actually visually see the days in front of me. So I wrote the song 20 days before I came home from an exceptionally long tour, and pretty much the song, it might sound a bit cheesy, but the song was written for my fiance, Gisela, yeah. The first blues song I actually learned to play was actually just that whole 12 bar sort of pattern, this, my parents were majorly into the blues growing up, so that's all I listened to as a kid. Yeah, so it's pretty much just that 12 bar thing. That was my introduction to the blues, and when I first stumbled upon that, I thought I wrote it. That's what I thought. I thought I actually wrote that, and I thought, wow, I wrote such a cool tune, but I thought, I've heard this somewhere before. And then when I started getting into the blues through my parents' record collection, I thought, wow, I didn't write that at all. Twenty Stones album is quite different to previous albums I've done. This one, I tried to marry my classic rock influences with my huge love of the blues. I'd still definitely say it's a blues record, without a doubt. The sound seems to make more sense, to me, and my voice playing. It really seems to be the next step musically for me is this blues rock thing, and I think that's where it's going in the world now. Or whatever, yeah. Yeah. Daddy's Old Gun is a song I wrote about this very interesting character I met in a small town here in South Africa. And I was at a car wash getting my car sort of washed on a day off on tour. And I met this old guy, and he started talking to me about guns. And this guy's about 90 years old. And he was telling me about this gun that his father gave him. I thought it was going to be a very sweet story, a sweet ending story, because it was like my grandfather telling me a story, you know? And the punchline of the story, if you will, was six guys came and robbed this old guy, and he shot them all dead with this old gun, you know? And I was so shocked. I was speechless after he told me that, you know? So I was like, wow, that's incredible. So I thought I had to write a tune about that, because you don't hear stories like that every day. Playing live's, for me, where it's at. You're driven by the audience. My best gig was many years ago in a small little club in Bloemfontein called the Downstage Theatre. And I mean, there weren't many people there, maybe 100 people there. You kind of let it all out live because there's no pressure of the tapes rolling or what's being recorded, or you need to impress someone or get something that's slightly more palatable, you know. But live, you tend to forget a bit about that stuff and really just let it all hang out, you know. And that's ideally what you want to do in a studio. And every time I say I'm going to do it, it's very, very difficult to do.
Like time is
So bringing the world to its knees is pretty much just about stepping up to the plate and really taking the bull by the horns and really doing something with this, you know, instead of just sort of always trailing around the back somewhere, you know. Working this world, a master plan. Bring the World to His Knees is my favorite song from the album, without a doubt.